Transgender Indonesians live in the fourth most populated nation in the world with more Muslims than any other country. I traveled to this archipelagic nation to speak with the male-to-female community in the city of Yogyakarta. This transgender community created their own religious space to worship, a space much like the mosques that dot the landscape of this island named Java. The male-to-female transgender community here call themselves Waria, which is a combination of two Indonesian words, wanita, or woman, and pria, or man. The religious space the Waria created can be translated as transgender school, or in Indonesian, pesantren Waria. The Waria have an ancient history in this land, but fundamentalist movements, dictatorships, and economic insecurity have reshaped how the Waria see themselves. The Waria went from highly respected keepers of culture and religion to highly unemployed street musicians and sex workers. The Waria see themselves as biologically male, but not men. In the US, many think genitalia is what gives a person their gender. Anatomy is not what gives the Waria their gender. Their feminine expression and sexual attraction does. In the US, gender and sexuality are separated. For the Waria, sexuality is not different from gender. Sexuality actually gives gender. And most surprising to me, the pesantren Waria, the transgender school the Waria created for spiritual belonging, is a place where the Waria are most masculine. They told me they want to pray as men, and when the time comes, be buried as men. Why would somebody who spent their life facing hardship to be Waria choose to act as if they are a man in the very religious institution they created to be free? The answer lies in how the Waria conceptualize gender and Islam. The leader of the pesantren is a transgender woman named Sinta.
Gender is sex expression. Yeah, not sex in our body.
All the Waria I spoke to either identified their gender as Waria or as a woman.
Kemudian punya orientasi seksual kepada laki-laki.
Gender and sexual orientation are one conceptual category for the Waria. Men are men because they desire women. Women and Waria are just that because they desire men. The youngest member of the pesantren is Kayla.
Waria itu sebenarnya ini terlahir sebagai laki-laki namun jiwanya perempuan gitu. Sama halnya dengan orang yang mungkin cacat dalam fisik gitu. Aku mengartikannya seperti itu, kadang terlahir, kadang enggak ada tangan.
Disability was an explanation some religious leaders like Zunli used to explain the Waria.
In hadith there is two term about Waria. One is khuntha and the second is muhannas.
She informs me about the two Islamic categories for alternative genders. Khuntha, Arabic for intersex, and mukannath, Arabic for transgender.
Enggak ada artinya, tapi yang tertulis itu di tapak tanganku dengan diriku sendiri yang menulisnya. Karena itulah takdirku, bukan takdir itu yang ditulis dengan diriku sendiri tapi dari atas.
The West speaks about gender with an assumption of innateness. The Waria speak of gender with an assumption of destiny.
Berbagi dengan berbagai jenis ya. Dan saya hanya menjalani hidup saya.
Oki is a 50-year-old Waria who's been coming to the pesantren for over 2 years. She moved to Yogyakarta to find the pesantren and kick her addiction to narcotics.
Ya, itulah di saat aku tuh seperti ini mau melakukan salat di masjid itu kan kadang-kadang sedih. Kenapa sih mereka itu kadang-kadang nggak bisa terima ya, di situ kesedihannya.
Karena itu sesuatu pekerjaan yang aku lakukan. Kalau aku sebagai identitas aku seperti ini, mungkin itu nggak melanggar. Tapi kalau aku melakukan pekerjaan seperti itu, keluar malam PSK itu setiap dimanapun agama melarang. Itu bukan waria aja, perempuan laki-laki pun juga melakukan itu berzina, sama juga dilarang melanggar peraturan itu.
Tamara perks up describing how she made waves, questioning the logic of her religious teachers.
I just asked, so what gender your God? Your God is women or guys? And they answer, God not women and God not men. And I'm berdiri, and I'm stand up and told to them, I'm your God.
Bunda was one of the regular attendees that came to the pesantren every week.
Saya penampilan sebagai cowok, walaupun hati nurani saya seperti cewek, kalau melakukan ibadah saya berpenampilan cowok, penampilannya aja cowok gitu.
wudu aja kan kita batal enggak, kalau batal kan wudu lagi, makanya kan sudah jelas kan, jadi bersih, bersih luar dalam gitu ya.
Lebih senang karena pertamanya aku itu sholat itu pakai cowok, pakai sarung. Karena aku kan biarpun aku waria, biarpun aku seperti ini, bisa aku ingin menghadap sama yang di atas itu. Awalnya aku belajar udah begitu, bukan dari awalnya aku pakai perempuan. Dulu kan aku mau pakai kerudung itu kan, enggak ah, karena apa? Bagaimanapun juga satu saat kan aku nanti kan disemayangkan sebagai laki-laki. Mungkin fisikku dilihatkan sebagai itu, tapi mungkin hatiku juga wanita.
The warrior noted they must be buried as men because their masculine name will be called out when their corpse is being washed before burial. Naming is an exercise in power and one that is foundational.
Memang kita seharusnya kita bagaimana kita lahir ke bumi ini ya akan kembali lagi ke bumi ini seperti itu juga. Tadinya kita dilahirkan ya layaknya laki-laki, ya kembalinya juga seperti laki-laki. Walaupun prosesnya setelah sekian.
I asked Sinta why she is the only regular attendee at the pesantren to pray as a woman.
Ketika dia menghadap Tuhan adalah saya tetap laki-laki. Saya tidak mau menipu Tuhan seperti itu. Mereka bilang begitu.
She drew a line connecting the warrior's perception of being authentic before God and being authentic before family.
Mereka ini adalah kebanyakan orang yang tidak diterima di keluarganya. Jadi mereka punya trauma. Trauma takut tidak diterima seperti dia mereka.
Before Ramadan began, the warrior rented a bus and traveled around visiting cemeteries. Since most warrior do not have blood-related family in the city, they pray over the graves of their friends. In the 20th century, a cultural shift took place in Java due to religious movements, where people began to consider the warrior as morally wrong. There is a Hindu-Buddhist mythology of gender fluidity still visible in Indonesia within shadow puppet theater called wayang. Wayang characters are important models that legitimize gender diversity because the characters come directly from Hindu sacred texts. Sacred fluid gender changed to innate fixed gender with the coming of colonialism and specific strains of Islam. Muslims have always voiced multiple opinions and doctrines until an ultra-conservative movement called Salafism began to undermine such diversity in Indonesia.
Jadi, untuk definisi yang paling mudah adalah dari fisik, ya, dari fisik, ya, dari fisik. Kalau memang dia adalah fisiknya laki-laki, maka tidak mungkin juga Allah memberikan jiwa perempuan pada. Nah, ini adalah sebuah keadilan Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah sudah tetapkan.
The conservative religious leaders I spoke to all articulated a variation on the theme of waria as homosexuals who are prohibited by the Quran.
Untuk saat ini, saya untuk membebaskan pada mereka. Tapi suatu saat saya akan masuk dalam apa sedikit demi sedikit.
Alternatively, the official religious leader of the transgender school says the waria can pray as any gender they desire.
Ya seharusnya sekarang harus ditelurkan fikih baru ketika kita menghadapi persoalan. Fikih kan sesuatu yang berkembang terus tuh. Dia berkembang sesuai dengan tuntutan zaman. Mungkin fikih baru diperlukan, fikih yang berperspektif HAM, fikih yang berperspektif gender, fikih yang berperspektif waria kan harus ada lagi tuntutan.
Kiai Muhammin has not made friends with extremists with such an embracing ethic. The waria threatened the social order of hardline Islamists. Interestingly, the waria and Salafists both share a concern for authenticity. One revolves around the authenticity of femininity, while the other orbits around the authenticity of the Hadith and Quran. Salafists believe they are more pure when they adhere to the norms present at the time of Islam's birth, 7th century Arabia. Likewise, the Salafi movement believes bodies are more pure when they adhere to their assigned gender at birth. A central fallacy in gender is to believe that to be more of one, you need to be less of the other. That is, to be more feminine, one would have to be less masculine. When the waria put on makeup and a dress, which increases their femininity, this does not decrease their maleness rooted in biology. When the waria stand in front of a mosque with other men, this does not decrease their waria identity. The idea of male on one side and female on the other creates a tug-of-war between perceived femininity and masculinity.
The Warya teach us to think beyond fixed, stable categories of gender and to view ourselves and our world as rich, complex, and nuanced. Gender is not an either-or proposition of only male or female. Gender is a concept incorporating various biology, expressions, attractions, and identities. Ultimately, the Warya reflect the dual nature of Indonesia, an identity that is both religious and secular, like embodying a dualism of maleness and femaleness.